Hi, George here, and today I want to show you the easiest way to remove a background. Right now I'm in Photoshop Elements. Let me show you the normal way of doing this, and then I'll show you the easy way. Normally, you go up here to Select, and come down to Subject. It then finds the subject. There we go, it's found the subject, and I could just hit the Delete key and remove that background if I invert this, but that's not the cleanest thing to do. And so we have some problems like right down here, little things like that. So instead, I'm going to go up here to Select, come down to Refine Edge, and using the Refine Edge tool, I'm just going to brush right along the edge here and just clean up that edge. And as you can see, this is actually pretty fast if it's a clean photo with a good separation between your foreground and your background. This will work out pretty well, and it doesn't take that long. It takes maybe a minute or so, not really a big deal, but again, it requires having a nice clean background to do this with and good separation. This has all of that. It's kind of missing right down there, so I need to go back, change my tool here, and let's just make sure we keep that bit right in there, and let's try that again. It's not quite catching that, so I have to fix that afterwards. Now I'm going to output this to a new layer with layer mask, choose OK. There's a layer mask. It's a little soft right there, but there's our basic background removal. Not that bad, didn't take that long to do that. But let's say we had something much more difficult, like this picture over here. Now, to be honest about this one, I've never gotten a good background removal on this picture inside of Photoshop Elements or Photoshop or Affinity Photo or any of the other programs that I use. We're going to see how this goes real fast here. I won't do the whole thing. Do Subject. This will select the subject right here. Again, we'll go to our Refine Edge. And I'm using the overlay right here, the Ruby overlay. And then you brush in, just like I did with the dog. You brush in, try to clean up those edges. And I could spend, you know, an hour on this thing trying to come in here and clean out these edges, and I still wouldn't get a good background removal. I've never gotten a good background removal on this particular picture. It just doesn't work out that well. Doesn't work here, doesn't work in Photoshop, and so forth. But there is a way to do this very quickly and very easily using an online service. Now, before we switch over, make sure you take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. There's a link for that right down there in the description once you finish watching this video. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at this online site for removing backgrounds. Here we go, site's called remove.bg. Now, I don't get any affiliate dollars from this. I'm not an affiliate. I just happen to like this site. So this is just a completely free recommendation in here. And the way this works, you upload an image, and let's try out that real difficult one. And I have it right here. Let's open this one up, and we'll see how it does. There's the original. And there you go. Look at that real nice background removal. And it's that easy and that fast. This is a great site for this kind of thing. There are two levels of downloads on this site. One is the regular download, and this is a preview image, and it's a fairly small size, 613 by 407, and this is free. If you want the full image download, this is your high definition image. This is good for printing, things like that. Then you'll have to pay a price for this high definition download, but it's real cheap. And I tend to use this site if I have things like this that I have to remove a background on and I just can't do it in my regular tools, then I'll come here. For anything online, for use on a website, if I'm going to put something up on Instagram or Pinterest or whatever, then the preview image is plenty big enough. So this is just fine for that. Let's see what else you can do here before we take a look at how to actually purchase the high definition. Again, it's inexpensive, so it's not really a big deal. Two things you can do here. One is edit up here, and the second one down here is add design. We'll start off with edit. Here we go. And in here, you can go over here to erase, restore, and this allows you to remove or leave in or store parts of your image. It doesn't improve the quality of the background removal, but you can take things out. Let's say I didn't want that little bit right here. I can come in here, I can brush that bit out just like that. If I decide I want to keep that, just click on restore, and I can then brush that back in again. And notice that also gives me the full background. So it's not a perfect tool. It's going to go up here and let's just undo right there. There we go. Okay, let's go back here to background. And this allows you to come down here and replace the background with a background of your choice right here, upload a new background, or choose one of their stock backgrounds, or just change it to a color. If you needed, for instance, white in the background, just choose color and choose white as your background. But there are a lot of interesting backgrounds here. Click on this one. Here we go. There she is with a new background. Let's come down here maybe. There we go. That's kind of fun. Now we'll stick with this one. Now right above here, You also can blur the background out to four different settings. A little more blur right here, more blur, and even more blur. So you can blur your background out right there very quickly, very easily. As you can see, there are lots of options down here for backgrounds. Just choose the one that you think looks best for your image. You find this kind of a nice full sky image. There we go. I think that works out well for this particular photograph. Maybe blur it down just a touch. And there we go. That makes a real nice shot. Now, when you're happy with this, you can come down here, click on download, and then you can download the preview version. And like I said, the preview version is fine for use online, for use on Instagram, for use on social media. Those kinds of uses, it's perfectly fine for that. Click on download. I'm going to download the image right here. And I'll put it back into the same folder. My other images were JPEGs, so they're not showing right now. So choose save. There you go. That's downloaded. It was that fast. And let's just back out of here. There we are. Now come down here to add design. This takes you over to Designify, which is another service that they have. We'll click on that one. Notice how it's opening up in a different tab up here. Here's the Remove BG, and here's the Designify. Another service that offers these design options. Again, real fun way to do things. Same kind of idea as far as the cost on this, but really easy to come in here and just add all kinds of interesting designs and backgrounds. Great tool if you're doing a lot of social media. This is a real nice option up here. So there go those two options right here. And let's now take a look at the full image size right over here. Now, if you sign up for a free account, you can get 50 of these preview images per month and you get one full-sized download. So if you only need to get one, just go ahead, sign up for the free account, grab your one, and you're all set to go. And you can sign up right over here, upper right-hand corner right there where it says sign up. Now, as far as the pricing goes, go right here to pricing. Here we are. They have two ways of doing this. Here's your free account, one free credit. When they say credit, that means one picture. So one free credit, 50 free previews per month. They have two basic plans here. Subscription plan, this is good if you're a business and you're doing a lot of this kind of work, then the subscription plan would make sense for you. I think almost everybody who watches my videos is an individual, not a business. So over here, right-hand side, and it's a pay-as-you-go. When it says credits, this is pictures again. So if you want to remove the background from one picture, and it's an important picture, it's $2. Not bad for full resolution. If you have more than that, if you have 9 or 10 images, then this is good, and it brings the cost down to half of that, just 90 cents per image. So again, it's not an expensive tool to use. It comes down to 65 cents per image for 75 pictures and so forth. So the price comes down quite a bit depending on how many pictures you have to use. I'll use this, again, for online images. That's your 50 free previews per month. Perfectly fine. The previews are just fine for online. If you need to print it out, then you will go over here and just use pay-as-you-go and just choose the one that covers how many you actually have to work with, how many images you have to convert. Okay, now as far as tools, this is kind of interesting. Go up here to Tools and API, and they have background removal tools, and they have an Android app. So if you work with an Android phone, you can do it in Android. Come down just a little bit here. We'll skip the command line interface, and this is just the online right there. We're looking at that already. But they'll have a Photoshop plugin right-hand side over here. Now, the Photoshop plugin does not work in Photoshop Elements. It's just Photoshop. And there's a plugin for GIMP, Figma, and a Sketch plugin as well. So there are some interesting plugins in here. And they have some other options down here. These are other plugins for different things, such as they have a plugin for Shopify, allowing you to remove backgrounds if you're using Shopify. A lot of people have Shopify stores. This is a great way to remove those backgrounds from your images inside of Shopify. They also have one down here for Gmail. They have one for LinkedIn. They have one for Flickr. So depending upon the different sites that you're using, there are possibly some options in here that can make that a little bit easier to use. So there you go. And again, I'll put the link for this right up here. It's remove.bg. I'll put that link in the description if you want to take a look at this. Now, if you like this video, hit that like button, click on subscribe, and take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. The link for that's right down there in the description. And I'll see you next time.